Everybody, take a seat. I want y'all to listen and listen good. The Feast of Dedication is a time where our people stood up against the heathen and fought back for the Most High God.
So Alexander reigned 12 years and then died. And his servants bear rule, everyone in his place. And after his death, they all put crowns upon themselves. So did their sons after them, many years, and evils were multiplied in the earth. And there came out of them a wicked root, Antiochus, surname of Epiphanes, son of Antiochus the king, who had been a hostage at Rome, and he reigned in the 137th year of the kingdom of the Greeks. In those days went there out of Israel wicked men, who persuaded many, saying, "Let us go and make a covenant with the heathen that are round about us, for since we departed from them, we have had much sorrow." So this device pleased them well.
That's right. Our own people were teaming up with the enemies.
Moreover, King Antiochus wrote to his whole kingdom that all should be one people, and everyone should leave his law, so all that the heathen agreed according to the commandment of the king. Yea, many also of the Israelites consented to his religion, in sacrificing to idols and profaning the Sabbath. For the king had sent letters by the messengers unto Jerusalem and the cities of Judah, that they should follow the strange laws of the land, and forbid burnt offerings and sacrifices and drink offerings in the temple, and that they should profane the Sabbath and festival days, and pollute the sanctuary and holy people, set up altars and groves and chapels of idols, and sacrifice swine's flesh and unclean beasts, that they should also leave their children uncircumcised and make their souls abominable with all manner of uncleanness and profanation, to the end they might forget the law and change all the ordinances.
And this is exactly why our people don't know God's laws today.
Now the 15th day of the month Casleu, in the 145th year, they set up the abomination of desolation upon the altar, and builded idol altars throughout the city of Judah on every side, and burnt incense at the door of their houses and in the streets.
They totally polluted our holy temple.
How did they pollute it, Grandpa?
Oh, it was bad, Judea. It was very bad.
For the temple was filled with riot and reveling by the Gentiles, who dallied with harlots and had to do with women within the circuit of the holy places, and besides that, brought in things that were not lawful. The altar also was filled with profane things, which the law forbiddeth.
Oh, Grandpa, that's horrible.
In those days arose Mattathias, the son of John, the son of Simeon, a priest of the sons of Joiarib, from Jerusalem, and dwelt in Modin. And he had five sons, Joanan called Caddis, Simon called Thassi, Judas who was called Maccabees, Eleazar called Averin, and Jonathan, whose surname was Apphis. And when he saw the blasphemies that were committed in Judah and Jerusalem, he said, "Woe is me! Wherefore was I born to see the misery of my people and of the holy city, and to dwell there when it was delivered into the hand of the enemy, in the sanctuary, into the hand of strangers."
Yeah, buddy, this is where it really gets good.
And Mattathias cried throughout the city with a loud voice, saying, "Whosoever is zealous of the law and maintaineth the covenant, let him follow me."
It was time to stand up and fight. When the Most High was with us, we were unstoppable.
Remember how our fathers were delivered in the Red Sea when Pharaoh pursued them with an army. Now therefore, let us cry into heaven, if peradventure the Lord will have mercy upon us and remember the covenant of our fathers and destroy this host before our face this day, that so all the heathen may know that there is one who delivered and saveth Israel.
It was time for us to put our foot and lay behind.
Howbeit, all the hindmost of them were slain with the sword, for they pursued them into Gazara, and into the plains of Idumea, and Azotus, and Jamenia, so that there were slain of them upon a 3,000 men.
Yeah, we whooped that ass.
Grandpa!
Shalom. This is Bishop Nathaniel of Israel United in Christ. Please subscribe to our YouTube channels. Stay up to date with our latest events, music, and classroom lessons. IUIC plans to continue visiting different countries where this gospel has not been preached before. IUIC needs your help in pushing this truth. So join us. Subscribe to our Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and podcast, and stay up to date with us. For more information, please visit www.israelunite.org.